Suresh Pandey. I am with Sindal Limited and I'm from Pune. When I came here for UX India, I was told that it was going to be a 15-minute talk and I actually came prepared. But when I actually started, I sat here and I've listened to a lot of presentations and I realized this is going to go down the dump. So what we are going to now do is we are going to simply have a conversation about what this particular topic was about, that was bridging the gap between user experience and customer experience. So like I said, you know, when I came in, it was all about giving a talk and I had to come prepared with some really knowledgeable sentences and everything like that. But I realized if I had to actually interact with everyone, these things are not going to matter. I would need to get down to everyone's level and actually sit with y'all and have a conversation with y'all. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to relate user experience and customer experience with what I am doing right now. Okay? So let's take an example. From your perspective, user experience would be what you see on the board. That's your presentation. What you hear from me would be a part of your user experience, right? But would it actually provide value from a customer experience perspective? So this particular gap that is always there between user experience and customer experience is what we actually need to look into. Okay, now I'm going to take the helm of the presentation and I won't actually walk through all the details. The next slide talks a bit about the details as to why customer experience is getting into a lot of focus. Now, y'all are users. Y'all have been using a lot of devices and y'all have been using and voicing your opinion pretty clearly. You yourself mentioned earlier where you said you wanted to hear a lot more examples rather than just theory, right? There are people at the back who say that, you know, it's quite boring to listen to people coming here and, you know, just talking without actually validating whether we are understanding things or not. So where she differentiated between what is user experience and what is customer experience. So what we will do is we will see those aspects as well as to why I feel that user experience differs slightly from customer experience. Okay. Now, just to summarize it, like I was saying earlier, users have started demanding, have started voicing what their needs are. And this has actually brought the users and the business teams closer, because of which business is having to actually stand up and take notice and do what the users need them to do. Okay. So moving to the next slide, we obviously know as to why customer experience is coming into focus. With all the digital enterprise coming into picture, there's a lot of focus on analytics, on customer, on mobile, on Internet of Things, on digital as such. The mobiles have also played a huge role in this. Now, when we talk about user experience and a whole user experience or a whole customer experience, there's a lot more that is involved. User experience would focus on the usage of a particular application or a particular product. When we talk of customer journeys, when we talk of customer experience, we are talking about encompassing a whole lot of other things. Now, this actually takes me back to my college days when I was reading a bit about marketing. And I had come across a term called as whole product. I don't know if any one of you all are familiar with that term, but this whole product is a term which was first coined by Regis McKenna and later popularized by Jeffrey Moore in his book Crossing the Chasm. Now, this particular definition that is there of the whole product says that the core product includes the functionality, which is then augmented to finally give you a whole product. Now, relating that to customer experience, I felt it would be good to define it, that the expected product will still be building a great user experience for the application, but supplementing it with unique touch points along with inputs from the marketing department and the results from the social listening, analysis from unstructured data and all the other sources to personalize it would be a feather in the hat. And then touching upon all other non-digital areas would provide the end user with a whole customer experience. Now here if you notice, I am focusing more on digital areas, mainly because I come from an IT service background. So IT service industry has always focused on the digital aspects of the digital touch points of customer experience and not on the other aspects. Now as user experience professionals in the industry, in an IT service industry, if we are to go beyond the digital touch points and actually understand customer experience and extend to that level, then what is it that we can do additionally? Okay? So for that, I will just quickly walk you through the four C's actually. Now this is something that it's a very typical marketing term. Marketers defined this, and this was defined by Robert Lauterbaum in 1993, and they call it as consumer, convenience, cost and communication. Now these are the four C's of marketing. Now if you see these four C's, you will realize that consumer focuses on the users, which from user experience perspective also, we also need to focus on this aspect. When you think of convenience, it is nothing but the where and how. So where and how is nothing but the number of touch points that the marketing would define for a particular brand, particular product, particular application. Okay, cost would definitely be finances that would be involved, but additionally what would also be involved is the total cost of ownership, which would include things like if a particular user had to switch from one service to another, the time that he would actually spend in switching the services. All these things would be the total cost of ownership. And the final thing would be communication, which is nothing but the dialogue of dialogue that the brand has with the consumer. Okay? So this is as far as four C's are concerned, that's the marketing angle. From a user experience perspective to sort of map it to the four C's, what I did was I put user experience in four angles, okay? This is the four P's, I call it the four P's. First is people, we all are a part of it. Problem. Problem is nothing but our user needs, the problems, the business perceptions and the user perceptions that come with it. The third is the project. Now why do I say project? Project is because after a person is identified, after a problem is identified, what needs to be done is a tangible result needs to come out of it. You cannot just have an idea for a problem to be solved and not have a tangible product out of it or tangible solution. So that's why I call it as a project. And the final aspect is proof. Now proof becomes very crucial in user experiences because unless and until we all gather proofs about whether there has been sufficient return of investment or whether there is further scope for improvement, it's not going to be possible for us to convince people that what we are doing is a good job or not. Now, we've seen four C's and we've seen four P's, right? Now, if we are to put these together, what we would get is this. Okay, now the question is, we are here today. Okay, this is where the marketing teams are. The question is, how do you bridge this gap? If you see, basically the same principles are there, but the marketing teams look at things differently and the user experience teams tend to look at things differently. We tend to look at it from only a user perspective and marketing teams tend to look at it from a business perspective as well. So as user experience professionals, it's going to be mandated on us that we extend ourselves beyond just understanding the users, but going to the level of understanding business and understanding the impact as well of it. Okay? So what while I was doing a particular project, I realized that it would be necessary for me to come up with a sort of guideline for me to actually bridge this particular gap. Because I wanted to go beyond user experience I didn't want to fall in the marketing play, but I definitely wanted to contribute in a way that would say that yes, I am contributing to something beyond UX. So for that, what I did was I created a guideline for myself, which I called as the four I's. Okay? Now these four I's are combine all these aspects and are focused on one, the first I, which is individual. So when we talk of considering user needs, we are also talking of personalizing user needs. It's not only a collective mass that we are looking at, but we are also looking at individuals. Okay, so we have to come up with a strategy for meeting user needs. That is individual. Then obviously ideate. Okay, I need to come up with ideas to modify process, resolve problems. Now mind you, I mentioned modify process here. I did not say come up with a unique solution or something. When I say ideate, it's not only about finding a solution to the problem, but it is also about finding where and how I can modify the process to achieve what I really want. That is what ideate is about. Then obviously, innovate. Now, when I say innovate, what I mean is using technology and understanding the total cost of ownership, I have to come up with innovative solutions. Unless and until I do that, it's not going to be possible for me to go beyond UX. Okay? And last but not the least, obviously, improve. Now, improve is along with gathering proofs for return of investment and establishing a dialogue with the customer while doing that, I'm not going to be able to improve or increase the scope of business. Okay, I'm going to leave you guys with this thought because there's a lot can go in it. Any questions we can take up right now? I have a few minutes. Any questions? Okay. I'd like to end this by yeah, go ahead.
Deals with the business goals and financial goals are that part. Here, basically, user experience is improving the existing existing experience into a better experience for the user. So, how is customer and user is related?
From user experience, we are bringing them to a point of engagement, but I think the ultimate conversion is what makes them the customer. So which is that gap you are trying to fill in?
So it means what?
Not satisfied. We'll have a conversation after the session.
Means the proper UX is in place, it definitely impact on the customer, the outcome of customer satisfaction.
Correct. But UX will always have an impact on the final customer thing. But customer experience is still more of a marketing domain right now in the industry. So the trend that is seen, not only I see it, but even Forrester folks and other folks are now saying that customer experience is coming more into focus, and that's where user experience professionals, if they need to stay, if they want to stay in the competition, they are going to need to compete, and they are going to need to understand marketing terms or marketing angles to actually ensure that what they develop is not only a user experience but a whole customer experience.
The term actually initiated from e-commerce, we getting
more and more popular.
When designing a product or something, in research and analysis stage, they don't take care of
they do care. They care. See, if you actually go to study all these things, you will realize that all the methodologies that are there for gathering consumer details or user details and all, those methodologies that all are always the same. It's the results from these that will actually make a difference.
Okay.
So marketers define or come up with that differently. User, we pick up different results from it. So that's what it is. Alright? Thank you.